do you think the ECB will concentrate on most? And do you think the ECB can act independently from the Fed?
Oh, yes, no doubt about that. It has happened once or twice in the past, although normally the world economy is very much synchronized, at least between the US and Europe in many aspects, particularly in what regards the market developments. But the ECB, of course, has to think about the European economy, and I think that they will decide today the first cut of 25 basis points after all the statements by most members of the Governing Council. If it would not happen, it would provoke a backlash in markets and a bit, you know, harming the reputation of the ECB. So I am counting on that cut.
Let's look a little bit into the future, Vito, as well, because clearly the market is currently only pricing in some 65 basis points in cuts until the end of the year. So do you think the market is perhaps too cautious when it comes to the power of the ECB of cutting rates? Mm-hmm.
Well, in terms of my expectations or say, forecasts regarding the way the Governing Council of the ECB will take decisions, I think that the market is not too optimistic because there are some aspects that the Governing Council, I'm sure, is a bit worried about. First, of course, there was this uptick of inflation in May compared with April, just 0.2 percentage points. But also, it was the first month where energy costs month on month stopped to decrease, and even a slight increase of 0.3. In May, and that will affect, say, the future. And then there was, of course, the jump in the inflation on services, which went up from 3.7 in April to 4.1 in May. That will be in the radar of the Governing Council, so because that short-term dynamics may create on some members some doubts about the linear continuing declining path of inflation. So I think that the Council will be perhaps too cautious itself, and so the market expectations are not off the mark. Although I think that there would be justification indeed to continue with the cuts until the end of the year, because wages have been decelerating, the economy is still very weak when compared with the United States. Of course, the first quarter year-on-year growth was just 0.4 after five quarters of no growth. So it's still very weak, and the forecast for this year is just 0.6, 0.7 average growth for the whole year. So the economy is weak, wages have been decelerating, and their own ECB projections point to an average inflation this year 2.3. I'm sure they will increase a little bit these annual forecasts for 24 in the projections that they will disclose. But nevertheless, being forward-looking, as monetary policy should always be, then there is, of course, justification to continue on a path of further cuts. So nevertheless, in terms of forecasts or expectations, I don't foresee at the maximum two more cuts this year, and perhaps only one may happen, depending very much on the data as they are disclosed until the end of the year.